don't know how to make it from one day to another, to the next, and you're trying to figure it out, and God saying you're still thinking too small, I want to give you something that's gonna change your life forever. Because I'm not just trying to change your life, I want to change your life for 1,000 generations. That your children and your children's children behind you will experience this. And that's what he spoke to me this week to tell this church. He said, listen, I tell them that I am going to change grandmama and granddaddy and mama and daddy's status for the children that are behind them. That our children and our children's children can live off of what God is doing for me and for mama and daddy. We don't be able to point to this is when our family changed. Because mama and daddy and granddaddy believe God. Well, I know it's something to say, but I don't know my mama. I don't have a connection with grandmama. Well, I come to tell you because God has allowed me to be the spiritual father of his church. Then today, over your life. Yeah. You must say, I don't have any children. He wants to change your life whether you want to have children or not. Right. And even your nieces and nephews in your family life. Well, I'm not connected to my family. Well, I'll change your life so that the church will be changed. The people that work around you will be changed. Somebody is getting ready to be promoted so much that they're getting ready to leave their job.
Thank you.
Lord.
All
right.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord.
Jeff, that's what he did to me. I have a job. Steady income. Good money. Passion with good money. Had been waiting on God. God, I want you to take me out of the job so I can pastor full time. Church agreed. Trusted God. We come out the job. Now, my plan was, well, this is my plan. My plan was, I'm going to wait in February to come out. I got about $7,000 bonus waiting on me in February. That was my plan. And I never give it. Dee came and said, oh, Pastor, go ahead and put 2 weeks in over there. I said, oh, from that moment, oh, Lord, I'm leaving $7,000 on the table. And God spoke to me and said, whatever you give up for the gospel.
Come on. Yes, God, yes.
And the kingdom.
Yes, Jesus.
I'm going to give back to you 100-fold.
Thank the Lord.
I said, I'm going to give you land, houses, you, mothers, fathers, woo! But watch this. The next thing you have to overcome in the meantime is learn how to deal with your persecutors.
Amen.
The reason some of you can't move forward is you're so focused on your haters that it's drawing your attention away from God. People ain't gonna ever stop hating on you. People ain't gonna ever stop talking about you. And people ain't gonna ever stop putting their mouth on you. If you would take your focus off them and put your focus on God and love them. Pray for them.
Thank you, Lord.
You ask them to forgive you, they ain't forgiving you. The blood ain't on you no more. It's on them. You said that you sorry for what you did, they still mad upset with you. The blood is on them. You are on your way somewhere. And I didn't let you know you already made it. I don't know where that word is from. Jesus was standing on the street. He got the fire ready. Now, when I say about leaving your job, God will lead you to another source. Amen. You know, listen. You know, when he told Elijah to go to the brook, God had a source for him. You know, you got to make sure your source is established before you move. I don't even call my son out, but my son said God is going to make him a comedian. Now I'm trying to tell him. I said, man, it's all right that God, you believe God will make you a comedian, but you need to know most comedians don't start out on Kevin Hart level. They start out working a job. They got a job while they're feeling their craft. And then once the craft takes off to a level that they don't need the job no more, they got to release it. I had to give you some wisdom in here because I felt some of y'all were getting ready to go need something that God ain't told you to need. You gotta get the direction from him so he'll tell you what to do.
All right, come on.
Yes.
Jesus on the shore. Man, I keep trying to get back to this. He's on the shore. Tells him to drop him in. Peter, I love my boy. himself up. He wanted to get to Jesus so bad, he left the boat and started to swim to the shore. And love that Bible said he got there the same guy the boat got there. Y'all are hearing me. Yeah. I wish somebody would understand. If what you own right now is not moving fast enough, no, put me on the accelerator point. Y'all know what I'm talking about? Yeah, you ever been in them theme parks where, as Melissa Felicia, who would call it ballet walking, you know, you step on the rolling escalator, not going up, it just
conveyor belt.
I got mad at her because ballet walking, that's what she called it. You know, everybody else can be walking, you can be going by. I'm trying to tell you, God will move you to an anointing of ease where other people are trying to work to make it happen.
Thank you, Lord.
You trying to figure out how it happened in your faith.
Thank you, Lord.
Can you receive me?
Yes.
I'm going to say, can you receive me?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes,
Lord.
Jesus is feeding, getting it ready. Peter swims to the shore. The other disciples get to the shore. And Jesus, all he wants is an intimate time with them. He was preparing them and he was getting ready to go. All they had known for the last 3 years was that they needed something, they could touch Jesus. And he had to prepare them because for what he was getting ready, what he was getting ready to promote them in their lives, they were getting ready to move into uncertainty where they had to learn how to depend on other folks. The last thing I want to give you today is, in the meantime, God is restructuring the people that's going to partner with you. Because the folks you've been partnering with, some of them have been a hindrance and not a help.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm also glad he's here today. Listen, this brother, I was going for a chaplain position. And he told me I applied for a chaplain position. Well, I'm going to work about 2 hours a week, you know. And we just met and connected. Thank you, Lord. I see what you're doing, Lord. You give us a point of reference. That's why you brought Jeff to the house today. God, you know, and we met, and I ended up not taking the job, but it built a partnership.
Amen.
Right. Amen. It built a partnership. And we went out there and prayed over the land. And Jeff said, listen, man, I'm going to tell you, it's already done.
Thank you, Lord.
He said, do you got any idea how much this is going to cost? I know exactly how much it's going to cost, because God showed me. And this is when you know you move the partners that got your best interest at heart. He didn't try to talk me out of it, and he didn't try to tell me, oh, you see how God will do it for you. You know God can't do that right here else. And that's what I mean by the wrong partners. You trying to move to something better, man. Oh, God, you know you can do all that. Man, you know, oh, look at how hard he's coming to you. Chopping all the hell with us. See, them wrong partners. You need somebody that God's going to connect you to, that when you say something big, and you go ask God for something, ask him for something big, and you don't believe in something, ask for something that's bigger than where you are, because that is not just about you, it's about changing the lives of people.
Amen.
God telling me to tell you, I'll give it to you if you're willing to give it away to help me.
Thank you.
Amen.
I want you to be a good steward over what's mine, and I'll give you whatever is the desire of your heart. Whatever the desire of your heart is, God put that desire in there, but you keep, I don't know who it's for, but many of you keep letting little trivial pipe dreams trip you up on your destiny. Sometimes you have to let some dreams go to get God's dream.
Yes, Lord.
On something that's temporary and it's trailing you.
Yeah.
your business,